Hello, my name is Marcel de Vries. I'm a weather forecaster for the Icelandic Met Office. And for the Reykjavík Grapevine's Ask an Expert, I'm gonna try to explain some stuff about the Northern Lights. The Northern Lights is, complicatedly said, an interaction between particles coming from the sun and the Earth's atmosphere, the outer layers of the atmosphere. Solar wind, which is also a name for those particles, comes from two different origins on the sun. And those are sunspots, which you can see in the upper screen, and also coronal holes, which are on the bottom screen. Sunspots on the upper screen are places with intense magnetic fields. And what they sometimes do, they become unstable and they explode. And then they are ejecting large amounts of solar matter outside into space. And when it is directed towards Earth, it can hit the Earth. Another phenomenon are coronal holes, and those are holes in the magnetic field of the sun, which allows matter to escape, which you can see here. The difference usually for the effect of northern lights is that when solar spots, sunspots explode, there is like a rapid and very dramatic effect, and the solar wind from coronal holes are like more gradual, more calm. And at the moment we are going towards a solar maximum where you have much more activity. And this means less coronal holes and more sunspots, which means that northern lights the coming years has a tendency to be a little bit more unstable, or you could say even dramatic. When these particles come to the Earth, they are interacting with the Earth's magnetic field. And there is a picture here to the right where you can see that if the particles are coming towards the equator, they are blocked. But the lines are going in and out of the Earth at the poles. So there the particles are able to come into the atmosphere. Where they interact with the atmosphere, they are putting energy in the molecules of the air and they light up, which is the northern lights. This is a website I use a lot to see what's going on the sun. And then you can see, have an idea what is coming towards Earth. So, for example, this is a graph where you can see all like low and high points. Here are peaks, and those peaks are basically explosions of the solar spots, sunspots. And here is, for example, you can make a movie out of it, and sometimes you actually see here stuff flying away from the sun. And that's the particles that we want for Earth if you want to set the northern lights. And when they come to the Earth and they slam into the magnetic field, stuff becomes unstable, and that's when you get northern lights. And a very good picture is this, where you can see green colors. There is slight northern lights. When the color becomes yellow, it's more. And sometimes that doesn't happen often, but you can see red colors here, and then that's a good possibility for very active northern lights. And usually when I'm outside, if I want to watch the northern lights, I constantly look at those pictures. And then the northern lights itself, you can also, from your lazy chair and from a very warm and convenient place inside, or like you can just check webcams. There are very nice webcams on Iceland, also in other places. For example, this is of Mount Esja to the north of Reykjavik, where now you see clouds. But here you can see very nicely northern lights. Sometimes even more than the eye can see. You can see now clouds, and that's a big problem. So it's not just you need northern lights, but you also need clear skies. And there the weather comes in. For example, we can look at a forecast for cloud cover. Those colors means like the blue color is low clouds, the red colors are medium level clouds, and the greener are high level clouds. For today, we should actually have clear skies, and that's nice to point that out, that this forecast is not 100% proof, because the weather model is going from the surface up to 20 or 30 kilometers high, and if you only have a layer of a few hundred meters or 50 meters of cloud somewhere, that already stops the northern light to go through. So you need really clear skies. I think I said pretty much. I think it's time to go outside.
We don't see any northern lights.
There are several factors you have to keep in mind when watching the northern lights. It should be dark and you should have clear skies. So we are now in the middle of Reykjavik. So to increase your chances, go out of the city. Also, like, try to find an area or a time when there are no clouds. Even better, if you want to have very dark skies, try to lose the moon. So if it's new moon, that's good. Also, when you come outside, your eyes need to adapt to the dark. So allow yourself some time to be outside. And if you don't see it straight away, don't panic. You just have to wait. Northern lights watching has also a lot to do with waiting. You just wait. Often, even when there is very much activity in northern lights, it's kind of quiet, and then you have a period of 15 to 30 minutes that it kind of becomes very active, and then it decreases again. So basically what you just need to do is be outside, enjoy yourself, maybe do a little bit of dancing to stay warm. It's very important to stay warm, and wait. Maybe we have more luck by looking at the northern lights at the Aurora Center Reykjavik.
Revontulet.
A volcano with northern lights. Doesn't happen often. An exploding sunspot. This is where it begins. Well, if you don't feel like standing in the cold, in the dark, or in the wind to look for the northern lights, you can also come here and be in the warmth and have it comfy and enjoy the northern lights here. Thank you for watching and letting me be the expert. Now I would say, enjoy. Ah.